In a world with global travel, animals and plants are finding it easier than ever to move to new places. And when they move to new places, sometimes they can take over, becoming an invasive species. A group of scientists determined which three bird species are most likely to become an invasive problem. Let's look at which species and why they made the list. Common Starling. This species is native to Eurasia and northern Africa. These birds have been intentionally introduced to other parts of the world because they eat some agricultural pests. The Soviet Union installed 25 million nest boxes to attract European starlings. And as omnivores, they are adaptable to whatever food is available. The birds easily live alongside humans, so their range has expanded with our range. Common starlings are excellent at competing for food, but they have another way to outcompete native species. Starlings nest in cavities, like tree hollows. The supply of tree hollows is limited and doesn't change quickly. Starlings can be quite aggressive in defending a cavity, and they're also aggressive enough to steal a tree hollow from another species. There are an estimated 140 million common starlings in the United States, leaving many fewer nesting sites for other birds. Red-vented bulbul. Naturally found in Asia, the red-vented bulbul has been introduced to many islands in the Pacific Ocean. They are aggressive and chase other bird species away from resources. They make bowl nests, so there's no competition for cavities, but their ability to spread on islands, where many species already are declining, makes them especially harmful. Like on the islands of New Caledonia, where they are spreading out from urban centers to compete with native species. The species they are outcompeting don't have anywhere else to go. The red-vented bulbul doesn't have the range or population of the common starling, but it has the same ability to spread alongside humans, so this may be an invasive species in your area in the future. Common Mynah. Another adaptable omnivore that lives alongside humans and nests in cavities, the common Mynah causes many of the same problems as the common starling. But the rate of its expansion makes it even more of a problem. Both intentional and unintentional introductions have occurred since the 1700s. Common Mynahs have spread to Australia, the United States, the Middle East, and Southern Africa. Australia named this species the most important pest or problem to their native species in 2008, and this spread was mostly because they are so well adapted to living in cities. The scale of intentional introductions was tiny compared to the common starling. Even so, common Mynahs have spread across the world. Common Mynahs are territorial and will chase other birds away from nest sites. They also sometimes feed on eggs and chicks from other species. So what can we do? The traits that these birds share is that they're adaptable, aggressive, and compete for limited resources. It's not clear what can be done about these invasive birds. The reason they are a problem in the first place is because they are so good at surviving. The United States poisons over 1 million common starlings each year, but all that death is only 1% of the population, and the population is able to quickly recover.
The National Wildlife Federation has information about combating invasive species, but they only talk about new invasions, not how to deal with existing problems. Maybe the best we can do in the future is just preventing new invasive species. It seems likely that we and our ecosystems will have to adapt to these species rather than them adapting to us. Thanks for learning about birds today. You can migrate to this channel by subscribing and continue growing your bird knowledge with another video on this channel. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.